afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Hey, well, it's great to see you. A year ago, we were supposed to do these two pieces, and a terrible snowstorm was forecast. And, of course, you never know how these things work out, as we found out last week. But last year, we had an enormous snowstorm, and so we made the decision a couple days early because our musicians come from such distances, we were afraid that people could have trouble traveling, so we canceled March Bach at Noon last year. It was the only time that we had to cancel a Bach at Noon performance. So we decided to keep the same program intact for March of this year, and here we are, hallelujah. Now, we're starting with a concerto for oboe d'amore. Now, a lot of you know, what does the word d'amore mean? Right. Okay, it's an oboe d'amore, an oboe of love. It's pitched a minor third below the regular oboe. You're going to hear the regular oboe in the cantata that follows. But Mary's going to play a little bit on the regular oboe first, and then you'll see the oboe d'amore and hear the difference of the sound. So here's the regular oboe. This is the soprano voice of the oboe family. That's the beginning of the third movement of the concerto. Now listen to what it sounds like on the oboe d'amore. So I think you hear right away that it's lower. It's a little rounder, a little warmer maybe sound, but very, very beautiful. It was invented about 1720 in Leipzig, and Bach became very fond of it and used it in a lot of his choral music, in the cantatas, the passions, wrote lots of solos for it, and this wonderful concerto. Now you may, if you listen to a lot of Bach, you may recognize this piece because there's a harpsichord concerto in A major that is the same music. There's some different notes in the accompaniment and in the solo voice, but it's almost the same music that Bach arranged for harpsichord, and then this concerto for oboe d'amore. Interestingly, there are not a lot of concertos that Bach left us. Of course, there are the two great violin concertos in E major and A minor. There's this concerto. There are lots of harpsichord concertos. And then there are the orchestral suites, the Brandenburg concertos for different instruments. But there aren't the plethora of concertos that we wish we had from Bach. And they, again, exist in other forms, in other places. Sometimes they use those movements in cantatas. So a lot of Bach's music was lost, and so we don't know what might have existed. But this is a gem, the concerto in A major for oboe d'amore.
Thank you. Thank you.